In this video, we're going to talk about carbon filtration systems, what they are, how they work, and how you use them when it comes to odour control. G'day Dale, how are you doing?
How are you doing?
G'day. Mate, I know nothing about odour control. Let's start with, what are we talking about here? This is not about in the home or BO, this is something else.
No, this is something else. We tend to have a habit of living in highly populated, concentrated areas.
And right.
By nature of that, we cause a lot of smells and odours. And there are ways to solve that, which we're going to talk about now.
Absolutely. And we're not just talking about arguably human-created stuff, so I'm thinking sewage and whatever, but maybe some industrial stuff as well?
Yeah, some industrial stuff, food manufacturing, anything from that to hydrocarbons, grease trap waste, just anything that may create an offensive odour to the public.
Right, and the more you've got in one spot, the more that all builds up.
Exactly. The more concentrated the population, the more odours we have and the more needs to be taken care of.
So talk to me about carbon filtration systems. What are they? How do they work?
Okay. Activated carbon is a very simple, non-complex way of dealing with odour problems. Probably the most popular version, and it's a very entry-level system, something that we can do very simply.
Okay, good. So what happens? There's an odour shows up, let's say it's in a sewage pipe, and you install what?
Okay, so let's take a treatment plant, for instance, or a pump station, maybe a bit more simpler to talk about. Mm. That pump station will produce a lot of H2S, for instance, which is hydrogen sulfide, that rotten egg gas smell
that you get from
sewer.
Yep.
We would take a vessel that has to be obviously constructed in a certain way to make sure that this works. We fill it with activated carbon, which is an absorptive media.
So you've got there's a situation where you've got lots of this rotten egg smell.
Yes.
How does the carbon factor in?
Well, like I said, the carbon's an absorptive media, and we can extract or passively send the contaminated gases through the activated carbon, and that will absorb the H2S or VOCs or whatever contaminants may be in the air, and,
okay.
And release clean air into the atmosphere rather than a contaminated airstream.
Okay, good. So you send the bad smell through the carbon,
yes.
And the carbon picks it all up and takes it away out of the air, so now everyone's happy. What happens to the carbon? Does it run out after a while?
Yes, it does, and that's one of the disadvantages to carbon, which is why we have other technologies that we may talk about later.
Yeah, what would be some of the alternatives that are a bit sort of further down the path?
Biofiltration, hybrid systems, misting systems. There are other ways to do it, but like I said, activated carbon is probably the most popular in the entry level. It's a simple one, it always works, but the disadvantages are that it is an absorptive media and it does have its limitations and it does need to be replaced.
So what we've spoken about is reducing odours using carbon filtration systems.
Yep.
Is there any way, what would you say when it comes to toxic odours? I think stuff that doesn't only smell bad but has a sort of a bad health effect. Is this helpful there too?
Yeah, it is. Like, activated carbon is not always activated carbon. We can't just put one sort of carbon into a system. We have to actually specifically choose a carbon to suit the odour source. So
okay.
There are many types of carbon. There are vapour carbons, there are caustic impregnated carbons, and that's something that we really try to make sure that we get right. So we always make sure we try to suit the carbon to the odour profile.
All right, good. So it's worth having a yarn and making sure you've got the right carbon for the right situation.
Yeah, always.
Before yeah.
It's
you
It's always
going.
Important to make sure that we choose the right carbon.
All right, terrific. Thank you so much. For those of you who'd like to find out more, please reach out to us via our website, bulbeckenviro.com.au. That's bulbeck.com.au. And feel free to send us an email, give us a call. We'd be more than happy to help you as much as we can.